2013 has been yet another year of growth for LTE, with more and more operators making announcements about their deployments. In some parts of the world, we have also seen announcements of aggressive plans to launch LTE Advanced, based on 3GPP Release 10 standard. This is an exciting prospect, demonstrating that the mobile industry does not stand still, but continues to evolve from year to year to deliver better performance with greater efficiency and at lower cost. But why is LTE such a success? It's not just a question of it being the best technological choice available to operators, although I would of course argue that it is the best technological choice. It is much more to do with the successful model of the existing networks on which it is built. The GSM Evolved family of standards has generated an ecosystem of some 6 billion worldwide subscriptions, and it is the size of that ecosystem on which the success of LTE will thrive. It is the economies of scale on which that success depends, and that will far surpass that of any other technology, and it is this fact which is of utmost importance to India. It will not be the millions of devices, but the billions of devices that will bring the sort of saving which will make mobile broadband affordable to all, external, available at a cost of €15, and that was before operator subsidies. There was also a €50 smartphone available. In summary then, it is the scale as well as the excellence of the system that will drive the deployment of 3GPP mobile systems. So what is left to be done? With LTE commercially launched in many countries already, one may believe that there is little more to be done to evolve the technology. Well, this of course is not true. With release 8, 9, 10 and 11 now completed, work continues on release 12 and beyond. Release 10 results in a point of maturity which exceeds the requirements for the ITU's IMT Advanced Programme and sets in place a further proof, a future-proof evolution path for many years to come. In addition, there are many new features which appear in 3GPP's release 11 and 12 and beyond, so the development of the technology is far from over. In fact, it has only really just begun. Many of those features are significantly important to India's plans to establish a telecommunications standards body, and that this may provide a vehicle for Indian industry to actively contribute to the standard setting process for ICT in general and for LTE in particular. In doing so, India would be joining with 3GPP partners from Europe, China, Japan, Korea and North America, and provide a unique opportunity to shape the next generation of mobile standards. Whilst at this stage we have no idea what 5G will look like, we do know that it is likely to emerge round about the year 2020.
We are living in a country where more than 75% of internet users are less than the age of 34 years. So that is one of the very good signs with which we can build upon it. And on the reality check side, if you see how the future of India looks like, right? The future of India is basically still we are having less than 1% of broadband penetration, both in rural and as well as in the urban market. Urban internet penetration is still less than 6%, so it means there is a long way to go, and the upside is very, very humongous, because still you have 800 million people whom you can provide this broadband. And as the session started, I heard somebody saying that still we can go and connect 750 million subscribers on internet. So just to build upon it, if you see, like, still 50% of Indian population is at the age of less than 26 years of age, which is equivalent to or more than Brazil, Russia and Indonesia total population all put together, right? And if you see this, it means we have still 40-50 years left with this population to use broadband in any form, shape or size, either on his social need or to meet his video on demand need or to meet his entertainment need. Right? So there is a huge potential which is in front of us, which we can address through providing internet or providing broadband connectivity. How it's going to happen? Yes, everybody's guess, like how many customers would be happening, so it's a crystal ball. You guess, I guess, we all together guess like how many customers would be there, but on a higher level site, you can think of approximately more than 400 million subscribers, as Pandit says, by 2017. So let them prove, and we as whole industry should enable this kind of infrastructure with which we can go to this 400 million subscriber base. Out of that, it is assumed that 371 will come from 3G and 67 million will come from LTE. And what it's going to do is basically what traffic shift we are seeing is basically now the majority of the traffic has started coming from the mobile side of the business rather than fixed line. Right? And what are the delivery challenges as on with all of us? We know like in India, the fixed line penetration is still very poor.